Yeah. When I pull up on a nigga, tell that nigga bad back. I'm too good with these words, watch a nigga bad track. If I die, all I know is I'm a motherfucking legend. It's too late for my city, I'm the youngest nigga rapping. Oh my god, oh my god.
Is this thing on?
Yeah. So I had to show y'all that I washed my hands and made sure I washed the sink and everything. So for you funny hoes, y'all won't say no funny stuff on them comments. You know what I'm saying? I'ma clean up. Yeah. Okay. All right, now let me give y'all a little backstory. You feel me? So I thought that this was salmon. Okay, the very first time I made this. But reading the little paper thing, it actually said trout on it. I never wanted to try trout. I always thought trout was nasty, but look at that fish. That thing's so big. It's bigger than salmon. It tastes just like salmon. It's pinker than salmon. I always thought trout was nasty because everything got seen. As far as on parent trout, the lady ain't like trout, and on Grey's Anatomy, Richard Rubber ain't really like trout when Derek made it or whatever. So I always thought it was nasty. Now, being that I watch a lot of cooking videos, I like to take the skin off because they said that it makes the fish fishy, and like who wants to like have skin on their fish when they eating it? So I had to make sure I take the skin off, and this shit was like, oh my god. This skin, like, it's hard as hell to take this skin off. It's easy to take skin off of salmon. That's how I knew that this was not salmon. I was like, it can't be salmon. This is a steelhead trout, so I had to use the knife. This shit, it was a headache, like, for real, like, it's annoying, so I'm about to speed it up, because it took me, like, 30 whole minutes to get that skin off, okay, real tough, nah, like I said, this is light salmon, so if you looking for a fish that's, like, cheap, this would be the fish to go for, because that whole thing was $18, so compared to a salmon that size, it would be like $20 to $30. I'm from Miami, so yeah. They tax on the seafood around here, yeah. So like I said, taking off the skin. Ooh, camera fell. Taking off the skin. Yes. Getting that camera. Look, it's so tough being like a YouTuber and like, you know, just starting off and not having a cameraman. I'm just saying. I had to get these angles. It took me most of my time just to get the right angle for this camera. But yeah, that's me. I took off the skin. Girl, how about some of the meat came off. It was stuck on there. It was getting me mad. Like, I was getting real, real tight. And also, when you wet this fish, like, it fall apart for some reason. Like, when you wet it, like, that's another thing that salmon don't do. But, I mean, the steelhead fish is really, really good. All right, y'all. So, I tried lemon on fish one time. Okay, fell in love with it. Now, I put it on every seafood that I make. Yes, it makes it really good. My family actually love when I put this lemon on this fish. It just, it brings out the taste in the fish. And it's just really so good, okay. Now we're gonna get the seasoning, right? So please understand, I don't have measurements for the seasoning. There go garlic salt, put a little garlic salt on there. I don't have measurements for the seasoning because black people, we don't measure, okay? We go by the gut feeling. That's something that's been engraved in us forever, okay? We go by the gut feeling. And don't talk about me, okay? That seasoned salt, I had to put it in that bottle because I threw away the actual La Riche sauce container. I got that Creole seasoning. I put that on everything, okay? Everything. Love it. Girl, fell in love with that in college, actually. Somebody put me on. Yeah, shout out to T. Thank you. All right. What's the next seasoning, girl? A little bit of sap, mama. Okay. Little bit of that, little bit. Look, like I said, okay, I go by the gut feeling, okay? So what I feel like is right for the fish, and it always come out perfect. I ain't even gonna lie. Like, I don't know. Cajun, I put that on everything too. Love Cajun, I love spice. I love it to be like a little kick to it. You know what I'm saying? Just a little kick. You ain't got the paprika. The paprika really don't do nothing. It is kind of hot, just a little. But I use it for the color because, I mean, I want my thing to look like it's something out of a restaurant, you know? So I rub that in. You know, you got to massage the meat, you know. That's the only way you make that. I seen something on the Food Network. They were like, you got to massage the meat to make it taste good. So that's what I'm doing. Very much just massaging in the seasonings that I just put on there. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes. Season that thing. Up. Massage. Ooh. Y'all see the little piece on the side? That just made me mad. Like, I don't like that. That don't look cute. Yes. Okay, girl. You done with the seasoning and massaging. Okay. Bye. Bro, I hope for everything y'all can see my head. You feel me? Y'all can't. Oh, well, what's really important is that you can hear me and that you can see this. All right, y'all. So, just like I said, I seen a TikTok video of this salad. So, I wanted to try it. I said, why not? Because I'm finna make some fish. And dude made it with salmon. And that fish, that trout, tastes just like salmon. It tastes just like salmon. So, I was like, all right, let me try it. Because it'll go perfectly with this meal. So, all right, what you need for the salad is, well, I got 2 cucumbers because I mean it's not just gonna be me eating it, so, and I wanted it to be more green in there than, you know what I'm saying, everything else. So I got 2 cucumbers, 1 tomato, a big avocado, some dill, and feta cheese. Feel me? I've never actually cook like with feta cheese, like that's not true. I ain't never actually cut it like this. I ain't never buy it like this. I had to go to like 5 different Publixes just to find it, and never cooked with dill. I've never chopped dill, never nothing with dill. So it's my first time. All right, so let's just get started cutting the 2 cucumbers, and this is how the dude cut it in the video.
Yeah.
Hello? Hello?
Juicing this tomato. Oh, I ain't gonna lie, y'all. This salad looks so healthy. This bowl is not big enough. It's not gonna be big enough. I ain't gonna lie. This bowl is not big enough. I have to get a different bowl. Damn. I don't really like adding unnecessary as dishes. I don't like it. Okay. I ain't gonna lie, y'all, never really cut an avocado. I never cut an avocado myself. Somebody around me always did it. I picked this out yesterday. Now, this is very ripe. This is a very, very ripe. Very ripe. Very, very, very ripe avocado. Okay. Like I said, y'all, I always seen somebody cut it. Never was I the one cutting it. I'm gonna take this little shit in the middle of it. Like the seed leaving shells and stuff behind, not okay. This avocado look a little discolored. Is it me? Maybe it's me. I don't really eat these like that. How you got that avocado out like that? Messy. Girl, like, look at this. Is this supposed to look like that? It's supposed to look like that, y'all. Damn, I already know this shit look bad. Like, too ripe. Okay. This shit look way too ripe. Extremely ripe. But I believe it's good. It should be, like. But all this mush. So, most of y'all don't know, but if you go back and look at my Miami slang video, that video I had COVID, so I really can't smell. I cannot smell a damn thing. Like, that sense is gone completely. I can't smell nothing. You could hold something up to me that smell foul, and I can't smell it. Scary as hell, I know. I don't like it. I want to be able to smell so I can smell things, but I know this ain't this because it can't be spoiled. Can't be. I just got this yesterday. Not saying it's impossible, but like. Oh yeah, better cheese. I ain't gonna lie, I was trying to realize what it is that he said, cause it sounded like he said pepper cheese, but I ain't see no, like, you know, the peppers that come in the pepper jack. So I was like, that can't be what it is that he's saying. Oh gosh, she's watching Grey's Anatomy. Okay. Cutting up the feta cheese. I'll put the feta cheese in there. I ain't never see feta cheese like this, to be honest. And what's the name you use? I will not be using. Like, why he cut it though? That's what I don't understand. You could just saying. I ain't really got the. I don't know. Let's see. finna rinse this off, rinse it off. I'm finna rinse it off. Rinse it off, rinse it off, rinse it off, rinse it off. Okay. I guess it did sound like this then. I don't think you don't use the stem, obviously. But like, I don't understand why I cut it. You could just do one of these, like right here, like that. Cutting it. Take it off like that. Boom, boom. Okay. Alright. Now I'm finna cut. I don't know. Is this too much? Yes, I'm gonna put some more lemon juice and some butter. All right, y'all. Damn, I hope y'all can see me. Fuck. That's not bad. It's refreshing. The cucumbers are really refreshing. And you got the avocado. And the tomatoes. Tomatoes are very, very, very juicy. Real balance. That's good. Yeah. Make this at home. Make it at home. Make sure you tag me. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe. Go watch my last video. The link is in my last three videos. I link every description. Last three videos are not too far. So, yeah. Like, comment, subscribe. Make sure y'all share. Don't forget to subscribe. You watching my... About 80% of y'all that watch my videos. You. Talking to you. You part of the 80%. You part of 80% watching my videos and you not subscribed? What you doing? The fuck? The fuck is you doing? Why is you hating on me? Why you hating on me? You watching me, you hating on me. What's the point? What's your problem? Okay then. But yeah, y'all make sure y'all subscribe and tune in for the next video. Feel me? Boom.